This is going to be an episode a little bit different. The current situation has affected everybody. Many of us are trying to change and implement a pivot within our business, and we don't know what anybody else is doing. I thought it would be a good idea to talk to several entrepreneurs and business owners to see how they've been affected and also know the strategies they're trying to use and they've implemented, learn what they're doing, and be able to hopefully pass messages that you can implement within your businesses. Welcome to Innovator Diaries, a show where influencers and leaders from all walks of life share their story and experiences. You learn the strategies and action points that have helped them find success and get to where they are today. You'll hear their stories and valuable advice to help you on your own path. These messages may also help somebody you know, so please share. So the three specific questions I asked are, the first one, what changes have you implemented to your business in order to adapt to the current situation? The second question is, what challenges did these changes bring? And the third question, is what you're offering useful for businesses in other areas? Why and how? People talking to us in this episode come from a variety of backgrounds, a variety of skills as well. They have different types of businesses. The whole idea is to showcase what the strategies have been, what challenges they've brought to the business, and what's working and what's not working. So I hope this is useful for you.
This is Sophie Den Hartog from Fresh Habits. We are a consultancy firm and we specialize in consulting regarding management development, talent management, cultural changes. And although our concept is not very unique, our approach is. We operate from the belief that in order for people to change or develop, they have to know why and they have to experience it. And especially this experiencing is crucial in our business model, which also made the current situation very difficult for us because although, of course, we could do sessions online, to create an experience online like we would do in a live setting is completely different and, in our beliefs, slightly less impactful. And of course, we want to go for the full impact. So our strategy in coping with the current situation is to ride it out, meaning that we have not made any changes and that we have made the decision to not join in the online red race, which is what everybody seems to be doing. But we are waiting. We are using our time to come up with creative ideas and solutions for the future. And when the world comes back to its new normality, we are sure that our existing business model will still have room. Perhaps it might be that it turns out that this is not the case, and that we do really have to rethink our business model. But at this moment, our strategy is to simply wait it out and to continue our business model as we had thought of it. Right now, we are using our time to come up with creative solutions for the 1.5 meter economy. As mentioned, we work primarily with groups. They have to be able to keep a 1.5 meter distance. So what does this mean for our solutions? We went from boxing in pairs to boxing on a bag. We need to think about locations. Can we still do indoor activities or do we always have to do it outdoor? But also perhaps we need to look at ways to minimize contact and we can perhaps find a solution to combine live sessions.
Want to listen to the entire interview? Simply go to innovatordiaries.com/episode number. Or you can find this episode and hundreds of other great stories on Google Podcasts, iTunes, Spotify, or whatever your favorite podcast player is. Please check me out on LinkedIn. Follow or connect with me as I'm very proactive on that social network. And finally, subscribe to this YouTube channel. You'll get all the new stories as soon as they're released. See you next time.